Good evening to you all. CitizenAY here. Next to me you have Dr Ladi Lawal, Dr Afiz Lawal. He's running for the House of Assembly, Eti Osa II Constituency. So good evening to you all. So this is a chance for us to the election for the House of Assembly is happening on the 9th of March. Oh, sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. Here we're back now. We're back live. Hi, Angela. Hi all. So listen. Hi, evening. How are you doing? Good. We're just having an interview here, 5 minutes. So we'll join you there. Thank you very much. Sorry. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's very noisy. There's a lot of people meeting up here. Can you hear me all right? Can you all say yes if you can hear me? Can you hear me? Can I hear say yes? If nobody can hear me, I'll change location. Hello, Doc. Yeah, people are saying hello to you as well.
Hello, good afternoon.
So if you can hear me, hello, nice man, as well, as it were, yes. So we have Dr. Afiz Pysio Lawal. Dr. Afiz Pysio Lawal. He will be running for the House of Assembly, Eti Osa II Constituency. Now, we got like 6-7 days before the election. So you're gonna hear there's a lot of people in the back there, but we're gonna have this interview tonight. So what motivated you to want to be the House of Assembly member for Eti Osa II Constituency?
First of all, my name is Dr. Afiz Lawal. I'm contesting for the membership of the Lagos State House of Assembly under the platform of AEC African Regional Congress. And my constituency is Eti Osa II. And I'm contesting for the position because I identify some gaps in my constituency and as well in Lagos State. I am contesting to represent my constituency, which is Eti Osa II. And the reason for contesting is to protect the interest of the electorate, particularly the electorate in Eti Osa II, and also the Lagosians as a whole. And what really motivates me is the ideas I have personally that I want to sell to the people. And I believe that my ideas will benefit the electorate of Eti Osa II and as well as the Lagosians.
Fantastic. Now, you and I, there was a video, in case you guys missed it, there was a video we posted earlier on showcasing the plans that... can you all hear me? Right, okay, there was a video that we posted earlier on that showcased the plans that Dr. Pysio, that he explained his plans. So, just to go into those plans, and you highlighted one of the issues about health.
Yes.
And the fact that our government was spending less in health.
Absolutely.
So, what plans? I know you went back home recently. What tell us what you've done recently?
Yeah, now, the first thing I would like to say, I want to talk about my agenda, my programs for the electorate in the Eti too, and as well as the negotiations. Now, my agenda has been categorized into four. The first one is the health, the second one is employment and sports, and as well as education. And each agenda has a steps. So under the health, my first priority is the provision of ambulance. And if you look at the population of Eti Osa, in Lagos State, I think it's around 391,871, which is 3.11% to the population of Lagos State. The population of Lagos State is around 22 million.
Wow.
Now, the reason I want to provide free emergency ambulance is to look after those who have a chronic condition, like those who are suffering from asthma, those who are hypertensive, those who are suffering from cardiac problems, and those who are having epilepsy and diabetes as well.
Okay.
Now, why I want to provide the ambulance, the reason is this. If anyone with that kind of condition has a new episode of that can take the life of that person, definitely that person will need a first aid.
Yeah.
And given the traffic in Lagos State, you see, do you think that someone who developed a symptom that can take his or her life, you know, can be managed appropriately without a first aid?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think providing an ambulance for a TSF 2 would be of great benefit to those who are having that kind of problems, because first aid will be given to them immediately.
Yeah.
And also, that ambulance will serve as a medium for taking them from their destination to the general hospital, but I can assure you they will stabilize immediately in the ambulance. And that is the main reason why I want to provide the ambulance. And also giving the population of Etiosa and as well as the population of Lagos State.
Okay, fantastic.
So the second thing I want to do, that is the first thing under the head. The second one is the annual medical checkup. So I'll be doing annual medical checkups for the people residing in Eti Osa too. And I've done that before. I've done that a few weeks ago.
Yes.
I've done that a few months ago.
Yes.
And we are able to screen a lot of people. We are able to identify those who are like, what those who are having some conditions as well. So we did a blood test, a medical screening for them, and they really appreciate it.
Fantastic.
Also under the medical, under the health, the other thing I want to do is to provide free medical support for people with mental challenges. Now, as you know, in Nigeria now, it has been well reported that about 40 million people are having mental challenges.
Yes.
And I don't think the state government is actually meeting
They're not meeting the needs, no way.
Of these people.
They're not.
Now, I'm very aware that apart from the medication people are getting, that's what we call CBT, cognitive behavioral therapy, it can be of great benefit to those who are having mental problems. These are the kind of things I want to bring to the grassroots. And I believe my idea is going to work.
Yes.
And I strongly believe in the time other constituencies will emulate my idea.
Indeed.
So it's going to be a big project, to be honest with you. It's a project that I intend to pilot for 2 or 3 years.
Fantastic.
So another thing I want to talk about the under the head is low back pain. There are a lot of people out there that have low back pain, and they don't even understand the cause of their back pain. I'm a physiotherapist. I've seen a lot of people who are having back pain, and we've seen few people who are having what we call red flags that they don't even know. So as a physiotherapist, you have done many postgraduate courses.
Yes.
I believe I have the clinical knowledge to help people to identify if they're having red flags.
Yes.
So I'm going to set up what we call back class program for those who are having low back pain in my constituency. So the other thing under the head is I want to educate people about transmission and prevention of HIV.
Absolutely.
This is very, very important
information.
Because
very
information is powerful.
Yeah.
I mean, it has been advised that people should use condom to prevent HIV.
Yeah.
But some people don't know that there are some condom that cannot prevent HIV. Because the condom is porous to HIV and to the virus. And that virus can easily penetrate. So these are the things I want to talk to the negotiators
about.
That if you want to have a sex, there's a particular condom that the virus can penetrate.
Yeah.
So, and also we talk about viral load. If you don't know that you're having HIV, maybe you expose yourself to high risks of HIV, and you don't know, you're advised to go for a test.
Exactly.
And the reason for that is this. once the person is diagnosed of HIV positive, there is what we call viral load.
Yeah.
That viral load is very, very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the two some people don't really understand.
Yeah.
To, you know, pass the message to them.
Yeah. So somebody, hold that thought. Somebody was asking, how will you curb problems of traffic congestions in your area as it regards, as it relates to health of Lagosians?
I mean, that is a very good question. Good question, to be honest with you too. I mean, I'm not here to criticize the current government,
mm-hmm.
but I want to add to what they can do to reduce traffic congestion. Now, for example, look at Godmiller Bridge. If you go there now, there are many lorries in the bridge.
Yeah.
You see, that is one of the causes of traffic
in
Lagos.
Yeah.
And one thing that is annoying me is this. Those who allow them to park the lorry on the bridge don't really consider the weight
of the
bridge
and
the
lorry. Yes.
It is likely that the weight of the lorry are even more than the weight of the bridge.
Yeah,
so
the bridge,
if the bridge collapses at any time,
people
begin to sympathize.
Yes.
They begin to give money. Government will begin to give money out to the family of the deceased.
Yeah.
So that is one of the things we need to do to ever quit the laws.
I know that the government said they were building the 1,000 freight trains.
Yes.
You know, they put that in place now from Lagos,
to the airport
and other things, and apparently they're trying to make it further out to go to Ibadan and further in.
Absolutely, that would definitely reduce the traffic.
So, but I mean, but it's a lot of work to do. Okay, now what I'd like to do, do you want to carry on with your...
The last thing I want to talk under the health, which is very, very important for the elderly people. Evidence has shown that old people who are over 70 years or 75 years, they are vulnerable to falls.
Yeah.
In my constituency, I've seen a lot of elderly people, you know, without even the assessment, and I know that they are likely to fall.
Yes.
And if they fall, what will happen? They are likely to sustain fracture.
Yes.
After sustaining fracture, what will happen? They take them to the hospital, they admit them, they don't even got the money to look after themselves.
Yes.
So what I want to do now is to initiate a program called Health Balance Track.
Yes.
So that kind of program, you know, we prevent the elderly people from falling.
Yes,
so
good.
So that is very, very important.
Very important.
Then, my plan, you see, if elected into that office, my plan is to assign them, they provide them the right exercise program in a group.
Yes.
And also provide them the appropriate walking aids, like walking stick, like walking aids that they can use in their house or stuff.
Can you tell us a little bit about your background, i.e. education, you know, the kind of things you do, you know?
I graduated from College of Medicine, University of Lagos.
Okay.
And during my studies, I was also a businessman in college. And after I
multitasking. Nice work.
So after I completed my BSc program, I started attending conferences in overseas.
Okay.
So I've attended conferences in Berlin, in London, in US. So after that, I did my NYC in Kogi State.
Okay.
So I served at General Hospital Kaba in Kogi State. And after that, I did my internship at General Hospital.
Okay.
So that was in year one.
Okay.
So fortunately for me, after that, I was awarded a scholarship by the European Commission.
Oh, fantastic.
To undertake the master's program at University of Leuven in Belgium.
Okay.
Also at University of Limburg in Ireland.
Okay.
So when I completed the program, I was on my way, but I wanted to go back to Nigeria.
Yeah.
But luckily for me, I got admission.
Yes.
You know, to also do a membership program, which is called the Irish Society of Orthopedic Medicine.
Okay.
So I completed that, and after that as well, I got an admission to to do a postgraduate diploma in orthopedic medicine by the Society of Orthopedic Medicine.
Fantastic.
In the UK.
In the UK.
So I didn't stop there. Yeah. I also did a postgraduate course at the Middlesex University, which is a 1 year program. Then after that, I also did a master's program in sport and exercise physiotherapy. And during that period, I was actually running two programs together.
Okay.
I was running a master program together and also doing a doctorate degree in the US.
Okay.
So at the moment, I'm self-employed as a physiotherapist.
Now, were there something particular that you did in uni? I think you talked about it. You covered it. Sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what? Why should the people of Eti Osa vote for you?
I like to use the opportunity to appeal to the electorate in Eti Osa to please vote for me. If you vote for me, I can assure you that you will never regret it, because I have good programs that I intend to do.
Mm-hmm.
And those programs will be of great benefit to them. Like I said before, one is health.
Yeah.
The second one is sport.
Yeah.
The sport one, I'm going to establish what we call Eti Osa Association, Football Association.
Okay.
So there will be a kind of annual competition.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe the youth will definitely benefit from that.
Okay.
As well. Another thing under the education.
Yeah.
So I'm going to provide free coaching lessons for the students.
Okay.
So there will be free jam and wire.
Yes.
So
yes.
They don't need to pay. So
no.
It's going to be free.
Okay.
It's going to be free.
Okay. Now, I'm trying to think of how else is. When going forward now, in the current state of things, what would you say that the people of Eti Osa most want? You've been on the ground a few times. What do they tell you, and how are you going to plan to actualize it when you come in?
That is a very good question, to be honest with you. What most people looking for is employment.
Right.
It's a serious issue,
yes.
To be honest with you.
Okay.
Now, if you look at the population of Eti Osa, like I said earlier on, it's 3.11%.
Yeah.
3.11%.
Yeah.
That is the population.
Yeah.
Look at the population of Lagos State. Around 22 million.
Yeah.
Now, within the 4 years, the Lagos State has employed 15,000 people. Given that figure, compared with the population of Eti Osa alone,
yeah.
You will see that is not even enough.
It's not anywhere near.
Now, how can we solve that problem?
Yeah.
The first thing, I've said it before, youth should engage in agriculture.
Yeah.
Government should provide land for the youth to engage in agriculture.
Yes.
I mean, we all are aware that there is no white collar out there in Nigeria.
Yes.
So we should look for an alternative to provide employment for the youth.
Yes.
And the second thing is this, which I think is very important. It is, the time has come for the Lagos State to provide a friendly loan.
Exactly.
Not only to the educated people, also to the poor.
Uneducated.
As well as the market traders.
Yes.
As well.
Exactly.
And to provide this loan, there must be a selection criteria.
Yes.
And the best way to provide the loan is for the electorate, is for the.
You can carry on. I'm just trying to ask a question.
So the best way to provide the loan, to be honest with you, the agriculture is very, very important. Loan is very, very important because you haven't got the job, there's no money out there.
Exactly.
So the best thing to do is for a lawmaker as myself, that is why I said, if they vote me in, I'm going to push for that.
Okay.
I'm going to push for that.
Okay.
The youth needs loan.
Okay, fantastic, good answer. I need to ask one question. Somebody is saying, how will you tackle the issues of street urchins in Lagos? What things will you do differently regarding housing for the low life?
Thank you for that question. That is a great question. I will
I will reflect you back to what Jacob did.
Yes.
He during his own era.
Yes.
One of his goals is to provide low accommodation
yes.
for the poor masses.
Mm-hmm.
And as I'm talking to you, that is not really happening
no.
in Lagos State.
No, it's not.
I mean, even in Lagos State, there are some houses that are not occupied. Mm-hmm. They are just there.
Mm-hmm.
And people are sweating, roaming around the street.
Yeah. Yeah.
So in terms of that, it's something personally I'm going to put as part of my agenda. I'm going to push for
yeah.
at the floor of the house.
Fantastic.
Because Lagos is very, very populated
yeah.
at the moment.
Yeah.
And
heavily overpopulated.
Yes. And accommodation is very costly.
Yeah.
So the best thing for me to do is address that problem is to present the matter to the lawmakers. So we can discuss about it and look for the best way to address the housing issues
yeah.
in Lagos State.
Indeed.
But we need a scheme.
You do.
To address that.
Indeed.
To be honest.
So I hope that answers your question. That was from Adelanwa, Adejoke, Adetuji. Angela asked a question. She says, I have a petition going on. Treatment before payment. How will you put that in place in Lagos, i.e. Eti Osa II government area? Treatment before payment.
Treatment before payment.
Yes, so people, doctors are normally saying before they treat you, you have to provide money. So she's put a petition, Angela's put a petition in place
okay,
to
okay.
say that we should treat people first before payment. How will you?
To be honest with you, that yeah. is a very, very good question. That is why I personally said I want to provide free emergency ambulance because that is a common thing in Lagos. And I wouldn't blame the medical doctors so much for that because some of them, they actually got a loan.
Yeah.
They got a loan to open a kind of hospital in Lagos State.
Yeah.
So what I personally intend to do for Eti Osa local government, I've said this several times,
yeah.
I've been doing annual medical screening, they are not going to pay. And secondly, I'm going to provide free emergency ambulance.
Yes.
And that free emergency ambulance will be like a mobile clinic.
Okay.
It's going to move around
okay.
within a Eti Osa II constituency.
Okay.
So they don't even need money before the treatment.
Oh,
treatment will be given. We don't need money because, like I said before, it's going to be a big project.
Yeah.
It's going to be a big project. And that ambulance will not be made only for those who are having diabetes, hypertension, epilepsy, asthma, or cardiac problems. Because those are my target or focus group.
Exactly.
But that ambulance will also contain some medications that will help those who are having malaria, just normal medical problems.
Yes, exactly.
So they don't need that.
Okay.
And that ambulance as well, as I'm talking to you,
yeah.
we can use it to convey people from their destination to the general hospital.
Fantastic.
So that is for my constituency.
Yeah. Okay, let me just see. Please speak about state tax. So, tax issues, how will you... I know that's a national and a state
issue. It's a national...
But does it have any impact on your local...
It does, to be honest with you. I will tell you now, at the moment, Lagos State generates how much from tax? Lagos State generates 436 billion.
Wow.
436 billion annually.
Wow.
You see, but we are not really seeing the impact.
No, we're not seeing the impact of that money. No,
I mean, I do appreciate the effort of the Lagos State government.
Yes.
You see, but we are not really seeing the impact of the taxes, on performances and also in terms of infrastructure. So now, the best thing to do, if the government is collecting taxes, the most tell people the impact. Or what they have used the taxes for.
Taxes for, exactly. They have to be spent, they need to give updates.
And you see, this is why Showore has been advocating for what? For a digital system.
Exactly.
To be put in place.
Exactly.
So we can track people.
That's what's going on. Indeed.
Because
indeed.
Now, they said we generate 436 billion annually, but there is no clear record.
No, exactly.
They give figures.
Yeah.
but we don't really see the impact. I'm not here to criticize
No, but you're just pointing out the things.
This is just my opinion.
Yeah.
You see, and let me tell you something. There are some people in Lagos State who are not supposed to be paying taxes.
Yeah.
But there are some cops.
Yeah.
They go to them and collect it from the there's no record for it.
Exactly.
But the most important thing about starting taxes is this.
Yeah.
If you collect it from people, show them the impact. Positive impact of the taxes.
Yeah.
You know, it's very, very important.
It is. Very good answer. And I now, you know, how will you influence? Here's my question. How will you influence the House of Assembly leader? You know, the person, the first and second in command, the House of Assembly leaders, with policies, you know, that you can benefit not only your own Eti Osa constituency, but other constituencies. What steps will you take to make sure that you can manage upward, in effect, to start changing the mindset of the people who are in power?
Now, you see, the first thing is this. Your question is very good, but it has to come under a concept.
Yes.
In terms of education,
yes.
In terms of health,
yes.
In terms of unemployment,
yes.
You see, now, one example I can use to change the mindset of the lawmakers in the House is to give evidence, is to lecture my colleagues that this is what is happening.
Mm-hmm.
How can we, what can we do, you know, to solve the problem? Number one example, look at the lorries they are parking on the bill.
Yes.
I believe some of the lawmakers are engineers.
Yes, they are. Yes.
And they know the implications of that.
Yes.
So in that case, you see, I'm going to tell them, has anybody got the total weight of the bill and the total weight of the lorries?
Yes.
And what will be the implication?
That
is the first thing. The second thing under the head, you see, is to showcase, to tell them that people are dying in Lagos State. In Lagos State, from what? From preventative diseases
and health issues.
And health issues. The first thing is looking at those who are dying from asthma.
Okay, go on, carry on.
And those who have died from asthma, and what record or figures of prevalence of those who have died of asthma is available in Lagos State. I'm very sure they might not be able to provide that.
Yes.
Because at times the authority is going to be giving out figures.
Yes.
In terms of working, some people have died of asthma, some people have died of diabetes, but they are not good when it comes to preventive measures.
Exactly.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Preventive measures is very, very tantamount.
It's very important.
It's very, very important. And that is the area I'm personally digging into. In terms of preventive measures.
Okay.
So let preventives, don't let it happen. When we have the issue of Ebola, you know, where people are worried about preventing the
exactly.
But they didn't put strategies in place to cope, to contain that.
Indeed. You know, this recent election, this presidential election we had now, we all know what happened there.
Yeah.
What steps do you think that people in Eti Osa should take to, one, protect their ballot boxes, two, to ensure that they vote safely, three, to be able to now count those ballot boxes safely? Under the current, despite the current conditions that we're facing in Nigeria, with the police and everything else, what steps do you think they should take?
The first thing is for them, after voting, they should stay there. If they want their votes to count, I would strongly please advise them, after voting, if it is possible for them to wait for the returning officers to count their votes.
Exactly.
Because the problem is this, you know, the electoral process in Nigeria is not that good. It is very easy to manipulate it.
Yeah.
Even after counting it, they will still need to take it to somewhere to collect and give results.
Indeed.
And that is where they usually, read. They give or manipulate the result.
Yes.
You see, so I'm advising the electorate of Eti Osa II to please, after casting your vote, stay there. Stay there. Let the returning officer count the votes in your presence. So you can know the result, and you also begin to call other police stations, what is the result there? I mean, something that we can put it together ourselves before the result get to its final destination.
One more question. How are you doing for time?
We can go on. Yeah.
Okay. One question I'd like to ask. It's now clear. Nigerians know a lot about the Bible. They know about the Quran. But one thing they don't know about is the Nigerian Constitution. Now, I'm proposing to start teaching our kids from the age of 4 about the Nigerian Constitution. And I've got a program, there's a page I call CitizenAY Constitutional Awareness Action Group, where I read the Constitution every week. Now, as an incoming member of the House of Assembly member, what steps will you take to ensure that every citizen of your constituency know their rights as laid down in the Constitution? Now, we know the Constitution is not perfect, but it's what we got. But I think to enlighten them with that knowledge would actually empower them to now ask the right questions of those of your people like yourself who will be involved. Because we need to empower them to ask questions of those they are elected into office.
Now, the solution or the way forward is we have a different ethnic group. So people are electors. We cannot understand the constitution.
The plan is to translate it into Yoruba, Hausa, Igbo, English, all of that. That's it. It has to be. Yes.
You see, there are people who begin to have interest.
Yes, indeed.
Otherwise, people wouldn't have that interest because the level of poverty in Nigeria is high. So do you think they will have time to even read it?
But it benefits them if they know, because they can actually, the infrastructure that they want, that constitution, under section 153A states, it is the duty of the government to provide facilities for and ensure the free movement of goods, services and people throughout the federation. So that means that the government are responsible, i.e. yourself, the government of power, the state government, the federal government, everybody elected. And that's why we need to empower them.
Mr. Ewa, said is absolutely right. What I'm going to push forward, if not possible at the state level, I can commend that at the grassroots.
Exactly. Now,
so that is going to be a pilot project.
Yes.
Now, what I'm going to do is to translate the constitution into what? To people language, Yoruba, and Hausa. People begin to develop interest.
That's correct.
You must look for something to motivate people.
That's correct.
So if the interest is not there, there's no way you can push people.
Yes, indeed.
So we have to look for something that will motivate people to read the Constitution. So if they read the Constitution and they understand it, they will be able to fight for their rights. Some people don't even know their rights. That is why they will not fight for their rights.
Exactly. That's exactly
the main fundamental problem.
Now, at this point, I'm going to say to people, for those of you who are in a diaspora, and if you are able to, please, I'd like you to download the Nigerian Constitution. It's on www.citizenay.org. I'll say that again, www.citizenay.org. I'll see if I can post it. Bright, can you post that link for me? www.citizenay.org. Now, one of the things that we're trying to do with this, with the group, CitizenAY Constitutional Awareness Action Group, is to make sure that in every local government area, that we will have a representative, that their sole interest, area of interest, will be to enlighten the local constituents of their rights. Make them aware of that right. Bring into play this idea of the constitution in the local languages. So how will you say, once you get in, how will you help us facilitate that? Because that is something that we want to put on the ground.
You see, there are two things. The first thing is to push for a bill at the floor of the House.
Yes.
given the financial aspect in terms of logistics, you see, and if not possible, like I said earlier, that means I might use what my own constituency allowance, you see,
okay,
to provide that.
Provide that, okay.
You see, I don't know how much a lawmaker gets, to be honest with you, but what I can assure is this. I'm going to start from the grassroots.
Exactly. And that is really, that's the key point.
From there, people can spread the news.
I see.
Other constituencies can emulate
what you're doing.
My ideas.
Exactly.
No, I mean, that question is very good, to be honest with you, because the moment people begin to understand the constitution and what the constitution says, and they know their right, they can stand up at any time and defend themselves.
Correct.
One of the main problems we are having in Nigeria, most people don't know what the constitution says. But having the constitution in their own language,
that's it.
To be honest with you, they will develop interest.
That's it.
That is the way forward.
That is the way forward.
Yeah.
No.
But they might, the authority in charge,
They will fight it, of course, it's not in their interest.
They will show interest because they don't even want people to
understand.
They don't
want you to know. They want you to just believe in the Bible or the Quran to keep you occupied.
Yes.
They want to keep your mind occupied away from your rights. So, ladies and gentlemen, two more questions if you have any questions. Right now I'm sitting with the House of Assembly candidate for AAC. He's running for the Eti Osa Constituency 2. The election will be on the 9th of March. So please, if you've got family and friends in Eti Osa Constituency 2, please urge them to vote for Dr. Hafiz Pysio Lawal. Urge them to vote for Dr. Hafiz Pysio Lawal. So he's the man for the job. You could hear he's got cogent and clear plans. He wants to bring up the grassroots to build those constituencies and build Nigeria. Because each of us in our local constituencies, if we start doing the work on the ground, we can build a better country. We can build a better nation. It is doable. We can bypass these people who are in power, who are looting. We have the power, but we first need to know our rights. So, is there anything else you'd like to add to say to us?
I think the last thing I would like to say is under this spot, I'm very sure there are some people in Nigeria who are disabled, but they got one skills or the other, because they are very good when it comes to sport, maybe table tennis. But they haven't had the opportunity in terms of sponsorship. So one of the things I would like to do for them is to start a table tennis tournament.
Fantastic.
For those who are disabled.
Yes.
And that is why I keep on saying that I have a lot of ideas.
Yes.
The moment we begin to show these ideas, other constituencies
will emulate it. And that's what we want.
From there, states will take it up.
That's what we want. We need that to happen.
Yes. So I'm going to provide a kind of avenue. Like those who are disabled, who are very skilled in that area, will be having annual competition. That is another thing I intend to do.
Now,
so I have an agenda program for my constituency, also for the delegations.
Fantastic. Now, how can people connect to you via Facebook? Have you got a page?
Yeah, I've got a page which is called Dr. Hafiz Lawal. You will see some of the programs I've done in terms of the medical screening and in terms of enlightenment programs as well.
Fantastic.
So if you want to communicate with me, you can leave a message on my page.
Okay.
I will surely get back to you.
Okay, I'll put the link for the page afterwards. I believe I have it. I will put the page. I'll put the link afterwards on this.
Yeah.
Is there anything else you'd like to say to us to continue to convince and encourage the people of Eti Osa Constituency 2 to vote for Dr. Hafiz Pysio Lawal?
I believe I've done a lot of work in terms of grassroots. I've met youth in Eti Osa 2. I've been to Obalende. I've been to my area. I've been to many places.
to campaign for her. And I will tell them my agenda personally. But what I will ask them now is just to solicit for their vote. And I can assure you, I will never let you down. Just keep a copy of this video clip. So, if voted through, then if I didn't fulfill my manifesto, then you can come to me at any time that, okay, Dr. Pysio said this, but it has not been implemented.
Incidentally, so, whilst he's saying that, there is a section in the Constitution. This is why I urge you to read the Constitution. There's a section in the Constitution where you can recall your member, that the person that you elect. It goes for all, right through the government level, from local to state to federal. We can even impeach the president. All of them, they are all impeachable. But all of these rules are contained within our Constitution. That is why I'm adamant that we need to teach every Nigerian this Constitution, imperfect as it is. So, but listen, with that said, it has been a real pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much.
Would you let us know how it goes, and we will try and promote you and try and encourage everybody to vote for Dr. Hafiz Pysio Lawal for the Eti Osa Constituency 2 local government area. So please, Nigerians, spread the word, tell your family and friends they need to vote for this man. He's the man for the job. Yeah, he's part of the AAC, he can do it. He's got the ideas. And
the ideas are there.
That's it. And all of the ideas, he will actualize the Spicer Heat plan as well on a local level. At a local level. So with that said, I thank you for joining me. And this broadcast will end here. I'm gonna bring out, we will now open and cover the main event where Showore is being received by Londoners here, and we're all saying a big thank you for the work is done. So with that said, I thank you very much.
Listen, thank you very much.
Really nice talking to you.
Yeah.
We should do this again. And good luck.
Bye.
All right. Bye now. Bye guys.